one of the most remarkable things that I discovered, and again, so just to take a step back, this is all discoveries that came out when Sigmund Rhee's diary was published. It wasn't published until it was published in late 2015, is that we actually knew who his friends were. And we knew that he was meeting congressmen. We knew that he was meeting senators. We knew that he was meeting Eleanor Roosevelt, Albert Einstein, Fiorello LaGuardia. We knew that he was meeting very influential people at this time. And by getting those names, I was actually able to go through the congressional record and see what these people were saying about Korea. And what I discovered is that from May until July of 1945, this is in the closing months of the war, there were repeatedly U.S. congressmen were saying on the floor of the U.S. Congress, we have to do something about Korea. We sold out Korea earlier in this century, and we cannot sell them out again, meaning Korea has to be completely separated from Japan. We cannot leave Korea in possession of the Japanese, and also we cannot cede Korea to the Soviet Union. Now, this created a big headache for the State Department because it was unclear exactly what they could do for Korea. They were convinced that recognizing the KPG would actually not accomplish anything besides probably encouraging the Soviets to create their own Soviet government in advance and march that into Korea. And also, they couldn't split their allies before the war was over. They recognized that Korea was going to be a contentious issue between the U.S., China, and the Soviet Union, and they could not let that happen before the Japanese were actually defeated. So they're under immense pressure to do something, but they can't do anything. And this just allows Sigmund Rhee to rile up his supporters even more and demand to know why they're not acting on behalf of Korea. And so I argue in my book coming out, it's actually quite a remarkable claim that I'm very excited to make, but it's all of these pressures from the congressmen, from the grassroots movement, that eventually convinces the State Department they have to do something for Korea in the post-war period. And so it's after the Japanese surrender that the State War and Navy coordinating committees are sitting down. They're trying to hash out a peace agreement with the Japanese, and they have to decide what to do about Korea. And it comes out that the State Department wants all of Korea. They want as much of Korea as possible. And the War Department wants none of Korea whatsoever. They say Korea is a strategic liability. Besides, the Soviets are right next door. We are still 6 weeks away at best. We can't do anything. And so the compromise that they come up with is to suggest the division of Korea to the Soviet Union. Now, they do this expecting, or at least half expecting, that the Soviets are going to turn them down. Because there's really no reason why the Soviets should say yes to this, because they're in position to have all of Korea. And their thinking is that once the Soviets turn them down, then they can at least tell these congressmen and the supporters of Korea that, look, we tried to do something for the Koreans, but we just were not in a position to do anything. We did the best that they could. However, as we all know, they don't get turned down. The Soviets agree to it, and then the United States is left to begin an occupation that they have no real plans for, and that they don't really, and that they didn't really want in the first place. The War Department never wanted that. And it's important to understand that I am not trying to pin responsibility for the division of Korea on Sigmund Rhee, because Sigmund Rhee never advocated for this at all. In fact, he was horrified by the division of Korea immediately, and immediately started protesting it. But what he was advocating for was demanding that the United States do something for Korea by recognizing the Korean Provisional Government. Well, this demand created this movement that then ended up in these results that he really did not care for at all.